ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause up here. Jason, the mom, our beautiful flower girl. Ladies and gentlemen, one more round of applause on the dance floor for the new Mr. and Mrs. Jason Blakeman.
It seems like just yesterday that we were watching Jess dance with her group at the mall. Her mother and I are very proud of the woman she has become. And if you really know Jess, as some of her friends know, she is very particular. And we are glad that she found a special love with Jeff, with Jason, who is a great guy, as you all know. After one of the holiday meals at our house, Jason offered to wash the dishes. So Sherry and I went to Jess and said, hey, this guy's a keeper. So Jess and Jason, your friends and family surround you today as you begin something new and wonderful. Remember your promises to each other, keep them with all your heart, and you will feel the sense of joy and wonder that only marriage can bring. Now it's time to celebrate. So we hope you all enjoy the meal, the dinner, the music, the drinks, and don't forget the photo booth, and have fun.
Cheers. This is secret. and it's up to follow. So, hi everyone, I'm Sean. I want to start by saying that if you're from Jason's side of the family and you don't know who I am, that's impossible because I'm a playboy. Joe, Paul, tell me. I mean, I'm in the family tree, it's true. Not sure why I wasn't given a name starting with J, but here we are. So, Jason, how many times throughout our 18 to 20 years of friendship have we been asked if we're brothers? I mean, seriously. Or even twins, for that matter. Mother. But I must say to everyone here that I grin from ear to ear every time that happens, because it's one of the greatest compliments I could ever receive, ever. It has always been and always will be the greatest compliment. Jason, you've been such an important part of my life, and it's the highest honor to be given this opportunity to be at your side today. I want you to know that you're my role model, and I could not be who I am today without you. MJ, your turn. As awesome as Jason is, he's still a man. And just like every other man in the world, he's perfect. Right? I know that you'll be there to make sure he knows that's not true. MJ, you're beautiful, you're bright, you're determined. And of all of the women in the world Jason chose, I'm so happy to. Welcome to the Blayton family. To both of you, Lisa and I are going to be here. All these people are going to be here. Whenever you need us, forever, you know this. Now, Lisa and I have been married almost 5 years, next month, and I wanted to give just one piece of marriage advice now that we're not officially tied. And this is very personal advice. I didn't Google search it. I didn't ask others for it. This is from my heart. Love is what got you here today, in this room, to a wedding, to a marriage. But friendship is what will see you through the end. That being said, let's toast. Here is to everlasting friendships, a loving and friendly marriage between two incredible people, and a healthy, fulfilling life. We all love you very, very much. Cheers.
Cheers.
It's an honor and a privilege for me to offer a prayer this evening. Heavenly Father, please bless us as we gather here as family and friends on a very, very special occasion, the marriage of Jess and Jason. Bless them, Lord, with everlasting happiness and everlasting love for each other. And for the rest of us here, Lord, bless us to your service. And bless this food we were about to share to our use. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
God bless you, Jess and Jason. God bless you, Jason and Jason. I was 10 and she was 6. But over those years, I've learned there are 12 words that preserve a marriage and make it happier. And I've used these words many times. I'm sorry. I was wrong. Please forgive me. I love you.
Keep going, Sheriff.
Short shirt, baby. Keep going.
I promise Jess that it'd be brief. I'm serious, Jason. Try those words. Thank you all. Enjoy your meal.
I think I want.